They have no place to go if it's not it's the most important thing.
A few weeks ago, my phone rang. On the other end, 80-year-old Beth Couples.
If I had the money, I wouldn't have called you. I would have did it myself.
Miss Beth called me crying, telling me about her friends, Patty, Sharon, and Christina.
The roof, it pours down. The water pours in.
She felt their South Bossier home was falling apart. And frankly, so were their bodies. Patty's in a nursing home with Alzheimer's. Patty's daughter, Sharon, was in the hospital. Her kidneys were shutting down. And her daughter, Christina.
Probably about a year ago, they did a retest on me and found 3 spots on my stomach and said that the cancer had came back, but it attached to my stomach now.
Stomach cancer and chronic pain brought on by a severe bone density problem.
When I wake up in the morning, sometimes it's hard for me to even walk.
So even if they owned a hammer.
I pray every day and I just ask God to keep me going.
There's simply no way these 3 had a chance alone.
After I hung up the phone with Miss Beth, I knew I had a hammer somewhere, but I figured I'm the last one they want over there working on anything. I did not have an instant answer for this person who clearly had a very heavy heart for her friend's family. So what can I do? The only thing that popped in my head at the moment, do what everybody else does. Post something about it on Facebook.
That helpless but hopeful feeling you get when you get a call from an 80-year-old woman who was doing all she can to help her sick friend and literally said while crying, "That's why I called you, Doug. I was hoping you could help."
Well, because every time y'all do something, it gets done.
I just asked if anyone reading this thought they could help with mobile home repairs. Let me know. And within hours of Beth's phone call to me,
I got the notification and I looked and somebody had referred me.
Fellow Facebooker Leo Savage had been tagged in this growing effort with no real plan or answers.
When I first got here, I mean, you know, my heart just started bleeding for him. I mean,
Leo owns and operates a heat and air business.
Doug, on the outside, you can see the light green mold.
But someone knew he knew a thing or two about home improvement.
We talk about purpose-driven lives in church. We talk about a lot of things that, you know, what is our purpose and how can we help serve?
Along with many of his church friends, he recently started the Do Good Project, and they have hammers, paintbrushes, and motivation.
The payment I get is the smile I get in my heart.
They'll need to transform this into a healthy, mold-free place for Christina and her 2 kids to call home.
Every night before I go to bed, I go over there and I talk to her and tell her good night and that I love her.
Because sadly, Sharon never made it home from the hospital. She passed away a short time after Beth made her call for help.
I kind of just feel like that's something that my mom was trying to take care of before she passed away. So it's kind of like I want to get that done for her.
All this area right here, that was it. That area right there, I don't even think there's a board there anymore.
The floors are giving way. Water is seeping in.
But you're going to be okay, baby.
And Christina's heart is breaking.
I know I've got a couple of people that I can call on.
But Leo is confident his group of do-gooders are up for what will likely be their toughest challenge yet.
It's one of the things that I found that I can do, that I can help people. And as long as you can help people and you can do good for people, you know, you're doing the right thing by God.